As a rule, mocap animations can be pretty long. Typically, we only need a part of it. Or we need to split one large scene into several small pieces for different animations. In this video, you'll learn how to select the desired segment of the mocap, how to copy animation intervals between different scenes, how to add frames, move, and delete animation intervals. Don't forget to like this video, and let's go! Let's open the scene with the animation that we prepared in the previous step. Here, I have a mocap of a character who is talking until he gets scared and runs away. For my game, I need to create a couple of different animations out of this. First, I'll loop the talking part of the animation so the character will do this forever unless interrupted by a player. Second, I need a different animation for the character's reaction. So, if the player triggers a reaction, then the character runs away. That is this part of the mocap. In the previous step, I've already created the scene without the animation with the character that I rigged. Let's open it. By the way, here you can add other objects surrounding the character. And you can save the scene with these objects. In the second tab, I have the scene with the animation open. And one of the simplest solutions is to copy the animation from the mocap scene onto the prepared character. I will only be copying the part that I need, not the entire scene. So let's switch to the mocap scene tab. To begin with, I need to identify which interval I'll need for the first scene. I want it to be a loop animation. That is, the character is standing, talking, leaning, and so on. And I need this to play endlessly, so that it's not noticeable where the animation ends and starts again. This means that the first and last frames of this interval should be as similar as possible to make it easier to stitch them together. As I'm going through the animation, I'm looking for these similar poses. I'm using the slider to limit the active frames area. I'm going through the animation and analyzing how noticeable the gap is between the end and the beginning of the animation. In any way, the gap will be there, but I need to make sure it's as little as possible. I can move the slider closer to the end of the selected interval and play the animation. I can also select the last frame of the interval and, using the hotkeys A and D, move back and forth between the last and the first key of the interval to see how much the pose changes. Here, the pose is similar, so I will limit the active interval accordingly. Now, let's play it again. This pose seems to be the most similar. I can visually mark the selected keys on the timeline. This button is responsible for marking all the selected keys. Next, I press Set Label 1. You can see the interval is now marked with the red color. Now, moving to the joints mode. Let's select all the characters' joints. Then, holding down the left mouse button, select the desired frames on the timeline. You can do this by dragging the frame slider, or you can simply click on the track name, in which case all frames of the active interval will be selected at once. Make sure that the active interval is of the required length. Now I can copy the animation for these joints on the selected frames. Next, I switch to the scene with the prepared character. Here you need to select as many frames as in the previous scene or more. You can see the number of the selected fields right in the timeline. If your scene doesn't have enough frames, you can add more by simply editing the number in this window. Also, you need to select the character's joints in this scene. and now we can paste the copied animation. In this way, I got the animation with the fragment that I needed. Now I'm saving the scene as a new file. All done! Now we need to create a similar piece with the part where the character runs away. Again, I'm opening my base scene with no animation and a rigged character. I go back to the scene with the animation tab and select the second half of the animation. Here, the reaction starts. And I clearly won't need this part. This is accidental recording in the mocap when the actor was going back to their place. I will label this part as well. By the way, you can use different colors for labeling. Just as we did previously, I copy this and paste it into the scene without the animation. Also saving this as a new file. And now I got two separate scenes with several animations that are ready for further cleanup. I'm saving the original animation scene as well to save my labeling. You don't need to do this, but I like to keep it just in case. There is also an alternative way to do this. You can simply remove everything from the scene with the mocap, except the part that we need. Select the interval that you don't need by dragging it, and then press the hotkey F. Now we can move the interval to the beginning of the timeline by holding down the middle mouse button. And now, save the scene separately. In my opinion, the first option is more convenient when you need to get several animations from one large mocap. But if your mocap is not too large, then the second method will work better. Let's leave it at this for now, and I'll see you in the next video of the course.